Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome, dear students. So, in our capsule production technologies lecture, today we are going to discuss the aspects of capsule production technologies. In our previous lecture, we discussed about the basics of capsules as dosage form, capsule shell manufacturing, hard gelatin and soft gelatin capsules and their defects, we discussed in our last lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss other advanced aspects of capsule production technologies, including the filling and overall manufacturing of capsule as a dosage form. So let's enjoy this lecture. After going through this lecture, you will be able to understand about the hard gelatin capsules, hard gelatin capsule filling, various principles and methods of capsule filling, and formulation principles of hard gelatin capsules. This lecture will be covered under the heads introduction of hard gelatin capsules and methods of filling, advancement in the filling of hard gelatin capsules, and the formulation aspects. So let's begin our discussion. Hard gelatin capsules. They are also known as the two-piece capsules or dry powder capsules. More than 85% of hard capsule shells are made up of gelatin. We have discussed in our last lecture also. They are elegant in appearance. They are quite good. Aesthetic value they have, fantastic aesthetic value they are having. They are easy to swallow. And the medicament is protected from external environment when encapsulated into the capsule shell. They provide the faster release in comparison with the tablet, because in the tablet disintegration is the additional step which is there. Here the rate limiting step is only the capsule shell dissolution. James Murdoch in London patented the two-piece telescoping gelatin capsule in 1847. They are filled with powders or more normally pellets. These capsules are made by the process of extrusion and spheronization. Capsules are prepared by placing a compressed slug of powder into one half of the capsule. By filling one half of the capsule with loose powder, and then the compressed slug, with the compressed slug method, weight varies less between capsules. In between the capsule to capsule, the weight variation is quite less. However, the machinery required to manufacture capsule is more complex here. Manual method or mechanical method. There are two methods of hard gelatin capsule filling. The filling in general has the five necessary steps. Number one, feeding and rectification, separation of body and cap, filling, then again the joining, and then ejection. So the five steps, these are important steps: feeding and rectification, separation, filling, joining, and ejection. Remember these steps, okay? In the hand-operated filling devices, empty capsules are hand-fed into an orienter which rectifies the capsules. The orienter positions over a two-part filler plate to house the oriented cap and body. A locking mechanism is there to secure the capsule body while the caps are removed into the upper section cap tray. The released locking mechanism allows the bodies to drop flush into the lower filler plate. A powder tray is positioned on top of the lower filler plate. Then, pre-measured powder is poured into the powder tray and powder spreader manually dispenses the powder into the capsule bodies. A tamper plate then packs the powder into the capsule bodies. So capsule bodies are now having all the powders filled in inside them. Then the cap tray is placed over the filled capsule bodies. Cap and body plates are then pressed manually. They are pressed manually. Best of fillers with a semi-automatic orienter and an optional vibrator are used for faster filling of powders. These hand-operated filling devices you have commonly seen and used in your laboratories during your undergrad and post-graduation. Please do practice hand-operating machines for filling the capsules. As you can see here, just what we have discussed, there are the two parts there. Okay, these trays are there and body and cap are put there, and then body is filled with the capsules, and then the upper tray is placed over it, and this powder, okay. And what you do, you press it in the last stage, and it is completely filled with the body is filled with the powder, medicament, including the excipient. So this is the simplest kind of hand operating filling devices, and you have commonly used these machines in your laboratories. Now, feeding and rectification method. Capsule fall by gravity into the feeding tubes or chutes. Uniform, they are aligned uniformly by mechanically gauging the diameter differences between the cap and the body. Okay, as you can see here in this step, rectified capsule fed in proper orientation into a two section housing or bushing. Okay, followed by the separation, filling, okay, and then joining, and then ejection. Okay, we'll be discussing them one by one, don't worry. Separation. In this step, the diameter of the upper bushing, the diameter of upper bushing is larger than the diameter of the capsule body bushing. The capsule cap is retained within the upper bushing. It is retained in the upper bushing, okay? And the body is pulled into the lower bushing by vacuum. Once the capsule is opened or separated, the upper and lower housing or bushing is separated to position the capsule body or filling. To position the capsule body for filling. So now it is ready for filling. So capsule cell is integrated. What you have to do, you have to separate from capsule to body and cap so that you can fill the powder into the body part. Okay. So once they are separated, it is ready to be filled. Now the filling method. In the filling step, the open capsule body is then dosed with the medicament. Okay. There are several methods by which the filling is done in the capsule cells: agar fill method, mechanical vibrating filling method, Dosator method, okay, and then tamping pin or dosing disc method or compression filling method. So we are going to discuss these methods: agar fill method, mechanical vibration filling method, dosator method, tamping pin and dosing disc method, and compression filling method in our further discussion. So let's take these methods one by one. Agar fill method, the number one method for filling. It is a semi-automatic method. Filling is primarily volumetric in this method, and a rotating agar blade forces the powder through a feed shoe into the open capsule bodies. And dosing volume can be controlled by number one, rotation speed of the body ring, rotation speed and design or pitch of the agar, and third, level of powder within the drug hopper reservoir. Okay, so these are the three different methods. By which we can control the dosing volume in the agar fill method. In the next method, mechanical vibration fill method, a level sensor located in the powder supply chute maintains a stable powder layer, and this layer then falls directly into the capsule body facilitated by a vibration plate. So what is step one? A level sensor is located there in the powder supply chute, maintains a stable powder layer, and this layer fills directly into the capsule body facilitated by a vibration plate. Then the accuracy of this filled powder is improved by the use of an adjustable spring plunger. It removes air from the powder, creating uniform density. Then the scraper removes any excess fill material before capsule joining. So this is a simple method, mechanical vibration fill method. The second method it was. Now we are moving to the next method, dosator method. The dosator consists of a hollow metal tube with a spring loaded adjustable piston. It is adjusted volumetrically to capture the powder dose. The dosator descends into rotating dosing bowl of a powder that is being maintained at a constant level. Once the dosator reaches the bottom of the powder bed, the powder dose is pre-compressed, and then the piston moves downward, forming a plug. The dosator then moves out of the powder bed and then aligns over the open capsule body. Then the next step, the piston descends to the bottom of the dosing tube, discharging the doses plug into the capsule body. So doses is plugged into the capsule body in the last step. In the next method, tamping pin or dosing disc method, fully automatic method it is. A rotating steel dosing disc is mounted at the base of a dosing bowl in this method, and the dosing disc has six sets of precisely bored holes. Okay, what is happening in this method? As the rotating dosing disc indexes the holes beneath five sets of spring-loaded tamping pins, a stationary tamping ring seated below the dosing disc retains the powder. After five tamps, a deflector isolates the powder from the disc. Then a set of transfer pins pushes the powder plug out of the holes into the capsule bodies. The next method is compression fill method. It's a modified version of the tamping pin or dosing disc method. In this method, there are four sub hoppers, tapping rods, and a powder molding plate. In the first sub hopper, A powder stirring agitator feeds the powder into the bores of the molding plate, while in the second and third subhoppers, tapping rods compress the filling powder into the molding plate and then it forms a powdered slug. In the fourth subhopper, a weight adjustment pusher raises the molded slug to a set height above the plate. And at the fifth section, a transfer rod places the finished slug into the capsule body. Now the finished slug has entered into the capsule body, so it is filled. So this is the compression fill method. Now you have separated it, you have filled it. Now it's the method of, after the rectification, separation, filling, the method step is joining. The cap and body housing or bushing are then realigned for capsule dosing. Okay, this is being realigned here. An upper plate or pin will hold the cap stationary in the housing. Okay, lower closing shaft rods will push the bodies upward. It is pushing the body upward here, as you can see here, into the caps until the capsules are completely joined. So they are joined in this area completely. Okay, this will engage the locking mechanism of the capsule shell. So it is locked completely. So they are, the body and cap, they are put together, they are joined in this step. Now they are ready to be ejected. In the ejection step of capsule filling, the lower closing rod or shaft will ascend. It will move upward. Okay, it is moving upward. As you can see here, it is moving upward. This will eject the capsule from the housing or bushing into an exit tube. Okay, as you can see here, it is being exited. The compressed air nozzle are frequently used to assist this ejection of capsule from the machine, particularly with the fully automatic filling machine. And then you can say this is ejected. As you can see in the ceiling, these are the ceiling discs. As you can see here, they are moving. The scraper is here. What is happening, that capsule is coming here, okay, with the help of conveyor belt set. Though they are the two ceiling units are there, first ceiling and second ceiling units, and the plate heater is there. Okay, so by this way, when they are moving through the ceiling pan is there. Okay, so what is happening, that actually these seals, the body and cap, are sealed with a slight heat due to the movement of the ceiling disc and the capsule into the conveyor belt slot. Okay, sealing can be automatic or manual. It can be heat welding method, liquid welding method, spraying followed by the warming and then setting. Heat weld method is most commonly used and most suitable for the gelatin based capsules. We'll just see the advancement here in the machines and the automation, that how these are made automatic. The process are made automatic. The capsule orientation and separation sections may be there. Okay, they are in this first station. Then capsule orientation and separation may be there in station 1 and station 2. Capsule cap scanner may be scanner are there. What is happening, that if some faulty, the free and the optional pallet or tablet station may be there, followed by the dosing station or powder pallet or via fixed or height adjustable dosing disc, liquid filling station or micro dosing station may be there. Okay, as you can see here, the free or optional pallet or tablet section is again there. Then faulty capsule rejection occurs in the seventh station or seventh stage, you can say, and free or optional pallet or tablet station may also be followed by it. The capsule closing with capsule body scanner achieved at station 9, and individual capsule ejection with ASB functions are there in the station 10, 11 and 12. Individual capsule ejection functions are there in 10 and 11, and then segment cleaning with compressed air is done in the section 12. So you can say in the entire cycle, the complete processes, these five processes are completed, and the sorting is also done in the same fully automatic machine of capsule film. Okay. Let's see the best all these method the steps of capsule filling in this automated system of capsule filling. In this step one, the rectification is done in this way. Okay, as you can see here, the rectification is being done, and this is the station which is operating. Okay, which is rotating in this way, that the stage two, stage three, stage four, and stage five, they are associated with the separation of the capsule, okay, into the body and the cap. And then the in station six, or in the sixth stage, it is filled. While it is being rotated, it is being filled with the powder, and the hopper is filling the content. Okay, and then the stage seven, the locking is done here. Stage 8 and 9 is responsible for the ejection. Here the ejection is occurring. The filled capsule is being ejected from the machinery and being sent for the packaging unit. And then stage 10, as you can see at this part, we can do the washing of equipment with the help of this facility. So the entire operation can be fully automatic with the help of rectification, separation, filling, locking, ejection, and followed by the washing of equipment and getting it ready for the next operation. Here we can see that the automation, that how we can make the complete process automatic. What is happening here, the capsules, the empty capsule capacity sensors are there. So when they are fed into the machines, they sense that from the empty to filled, the filled capsule capacity sensor are there, and empty capsule capacity sensors are there. So both the readings are there in the NETT, weight control system is there. So what is happening, that the sorting can be done very easily, automatically, by chance. If some particular capsule is not having the prescribed weight, it is sorted out. So this is and the report can be generated automatically. Okay, so with the help of it is calibrated with the help of doser. So exact dose, if is not there in the capsule and it is not having that particular weight, it is sorted out automatically by this automatic system of capsule filling machine. Okay. However, the manual sampling can also be done. It has got the provision of the manual sampling in this kind of automatic machines also. Now, what are the formulation aspects? Let's see the biopharmaceutical aspects first. The formulation factors which influence the bioavailability of drugs from hard gelatin capsules are, number one, surface area of particle size of the drug. A reduction in the particle size is not a solution for all problems, because agglomeration effects may prevail. Use of the salt form of a drug in preference to the parent weak acid or base, crystal form of the drug, chemical stability of the drug in the doses form, and GI fluids. There are some important aspects which are in general associated with the tablets also. They are also applicable here in the biopharmaceutical properties of the capsules. Nature and quantity of the diluent, lubricant, and wetting agents are also important to be considered. Drug excipient interactions with respect to the absorption, complexation, they are utmost important to be studied. Types and condition of filling process, what kind of filling process you are adopting. Packing density of the capsule contents, they are also important. And composition and properties of the capsule cell are utmost important with respect to the biopharmaceutical aspects for considering into the formulation for the formulation of the capsule dosage forms. Interaction between the capsule cell and contents must also be observed and should be taken care of for formulation development. What are the formulation principles for the hard gelatin capsules? The sections of the section of diluent filler related to the solubility of active ingredient to aid and not interfere with dissolution. They should not interfere with the dissolution. For poorly soluble active constituents, select a soluble excipient like lactose. For soluble active, select an insoluble excipient like starch. By this way, we can have this is a common principle. You can say this is a principle for formulation for hard gelatin capsules. The choice of diluent or filler dictates the plug forming capability at low compression force of 10 to 100 Newton. Such fillers modified for direct compression tableting, they have got the advanced flowability and compactability and may be of special advantage in automatic filling machines that form plugs by tamping or compression. Okay, so these fillers are modified for direct compression and tableting with enhanced flowability and compactability. Laminar lubricants like magnesium stearate, they should not be over blended. High shearing of blending may lead to the may be used for the more hydrophobic particles in the blend, may add the high shearing may add the more hydrophobic particles into the blend. So if too much glidant is used, if you are using too much glidant, they can act as an anti-glidant. Okay, they can act as an anti-glidant. So don't use glidant much. Water content of the fill should not more than 5%. Doses greater than 600 milligram in powder form, they are virtually impossible to fill. So always remember to have an idea about what dose you are filling. It may be possible to produce such doses in hard gelatin capsule form by increasing the density of the formulation. For instance, by granulation, we can increase the density. The density affects fill weight and size of the capsule. Flow affects the bed recovery and segregation. So these have the different aspects and different impact on the overall capsule blend properties. The adhesion, it affects the fill weight uniformly, the fill weight uniformity, potency drop, segregation, and electrostatic interactions. Water content affects the wettability, dissolution, and shell and content stability, while the compactability affects the fill weight uniformity, plug formation, tamp compression pressure, plug retention in dosing tubes and dosing disc and dissolution. While the compressibility affects the fill weight, tamp compression pressure and capsule size selection. So these are the important capsule blend properties. So let me give you some references. These are some of the important references for your further readings. Please go ahead with the capsule production technologies from these references. What is the takeaway message? What is the summary? Let's summarize our entire discussion of this lecture. That hard gelatin capsules as dosage form, we discussed their importance, we discussed various methods of filling of hard gelatin capsules, including the manual method which you perform in the laboratories, okay, handheld devices we discussed. And after that we discussed the advanced capsule filling technologies. With the help of those technologies we can do the rectification, then separation, filling, joining, okay, ejection and ejection. So these are followed by the washing of these machines. Automatic sorting can be done on the basis of the weight. And we discussed the various formulation concentration of hard gelatin capsules. Please do refer the further readings which we have mentioned, which we have given for you. And remember the thing that the blending properties are very much important when we are discussing for various methods of capsule productions. And do remember the various filling methods which we discussed in our lecture, their names and each and every methods processing and their individual merits and demerits you must go through from the text, so that you should be able to adopt a particularly more suitable filling method depending upon your requirement. So this was all about the hard gelatin capsule manufacturing, capsule production technologies. We'll be coming back with soft gelatin capsules and the quality control of capsule as a dosage form in our next lecture. So stay tuned and happy learning. Thank you.